So I wanted to offer up some additional buying advice to all of you beautiful humans out there as we start to round the corner of the M1X Mac announcements and the releases. And I want to be very clear. Well, first off, I didn't get an invite today, but this is also not a video about repeating leaks and headlines, but rather because I know some of you really love this while others just are really over it. But it's pretty much clear as clear as mud can be that we'll be seeing the reintroduction of legacy ports that aren't really legacy. And somehow Apple will have decided to re-gift us with the mere pleasure of having more pluggable access while we consume our ProRes footage on the gorgeous displays that will all have been filmed on the iPhone 13 Pro before realizing what a pain it is to get ProRes footage off of these devices through the Lightning port, or better yet, that convenient AirDrop that'll just take hours to transfer that onto these new M1X Macs. But I'll of course get to the point that when these devices are officially announced, if you are truly considering making this investment, I wouldn't hesitate on pre-ordering or purchasing right away, like immediately, especially if you're putting together a built-to-order device with upgraded RAM or storage. And you know me, I always recommend upgraded RAM. But since I've started sharing my experience through the reviews on this channel and offer like the best advice that I can offer you based on my findings at the time, there has since been a few common themes that I've seen throughout my comment section here, as well as on other platforms, and even my own businesses that have either had to scale down or be put on pause for the reasons that I will share with you. And of course, first, when the M1s were announced, there was definitely a lot of buzz around this because Apple had been teasing this out. And for those of us that follow tech the way that we actually follow tech, we just had this gut feeling that we were finally going to be getting something different. I at least felt that way. And yes, we knew that this wasn't brand new technology, but you know, with Apple, it's really not about being first. But with all of the reviews hitting your feeds and the excitement around these devices, there was a lot happening. Everybody was starting to pay attention. And then you decided to jump on the Apple cart to find that this excitement resonated with a lot of others out there. And your orders went from weeks and in some cases, unfortunately, months before you could get your device, especially if you wanted any type of upgrade. And of course, not to mention that I live in the States where the availability of these devices are much easier to find. But for those of you in other parts of the world, it seemed to be near impossible to find an M1. Which of course brings me to my point that manufacturing delays that have occurred over the last year due to what has been happening in the world has still been an ongoing issue this year. And I realize we did see headlines and stories that as early as April of this year, 2021, that Apple had already started the production of the successor, which of course led to the rumors of a possible announcement of the M1X at WWDC. So of course, with this continued ripple effect, we're seeing this spread throughout multiple product lines and businesses. Even Apple is at the mercy of these bottlenecks. And although not as impacted as other industries, but answering to, of course, their customers and shareholders, they've been in a constant pivot to ink these deals for exclusivity. But let's also highlight that these delays are popping up due to the power outages in China and the government putting pressure on manufacturers to basically throttle this back. And some of these suppliers may only be producing like one or like two components for some of these pieces of tech that of course contain many other moving parts, but those one or two components are holding up that product getting to market. And this isn't often being discussed within the tech community, but a lot of this is being driven by China's plan to combat climate change. And of course, folks, here's the thing. We are not going to be taking a political right or left on this topic, but this is a real agenda that influences how we both consume and how we produce. And as much as we want to assume that Apple is, of course, ripping off the consumer by removing the charging brick from the iPhones and even before that, the wired earpods, and then even making fun of Samsung, because as much as these brands have taken a dig at Apple over the years, it seems that they are also falling in line. But is it really because these brands want to be more like Apple as a consumer-facing brand? Or is it about saving money and ultimately looking like they too are shortchanging the consumer? Or is it really coming down to preference and exclusivity with these manufacturing deals? Because there seems to be these proposed subsidies through tax credits that these suppliers are getting to fast track the compliance with these environmental agendas. So if these suppliers can show that they're trying to make strides in these efforts, they're also partnering with brands that are also willing to implement their own policies, which may involve removing previously offered accessories, smaller or recycled packaging, or even putting some additional R&D into their actual product lines to offer more performance with less power demands, then that too could be a consideration. And although, to be fair, in like Apple's refusal of removing the Lightning port, it only seems to be encouraging the use of additional adapters and dongles for those that are trying to either push an external display or have the ability to move files to or from an external SSD or a camera, or really just trying to embrace the current USB-C standard. But getting back to logistics and bringing products to market, this is where I'm encouraging you to get ready to hit that buy button. Not because I'm looking for some clickbait title that indicates that you have to have this device and you can't live without it, but for those of you who have been waiting and putting this purchase on hold since the M1 was released in 2020, I really wouldn't sit on your hands because the demand with these products is also fueling the delays. And as I've said before, that being wrong is not an issue for me because I'll welcome the correction and I will admit it, I'll fix it if that is needed, and I will keep moving forward. And adding in the Great Resignation on top of these global manufacturing delays has also been a challenge for businesses. And I am literally on a very long pause with some of these businesses. I can't even launch them right now. And, you know, like I think I did mention this in another video, but in some industries, this is just pure competition on the back end. And some of us just can't even compete for exclusivity on that level of scale. Maybe I just need deeper pockets. But of course, maybe if you end up liking this video for the algorithm, that might help move this along a little quicker. But what I want to say is that I also mentioned before that you really should consider figuring out what your budget is. What are the features that will really sell? Like, what will sell this for you? And what is it going to be that's just going to take this deal right off the table for you? And I have mentioned before that I do believe that the M1X lineup will be coming at a steeper price than the M1s, which I think that's an obvious. And I just really want you to go in as informed as you can and really look at your workflow. And I'm certainly not opposed to waiting on deals that might pop up over the holidays or as stores can offer discounts, because as they're moving these devices so quickly, they can take a little off the top because of the sheer volume. But do consider the loss in whatever it is that you're trying to accomplish in the discount, that it may end up costing you those gains in the end. And not to mention that we really haven't been great at predicting an end in sight to these global delays. But if you want to wait until the review units get to the creators that oftentimes get first dibs on testing these devices, or until creators like myself start diving in on the testing, that's of course fine too. But this isn't about spending money you don't have or that you can't make back. Even if you order through Apple or another store, please take advantage of the ability to cancel the order that you may have placed on pre-order, get familiar with any of the return policies, and even consider retailers or credit cards that may offer you extra benefits that give you time to explore these devices for yourselves and not having to kick yourself because you may have to wait longer. And here's the thing, it's your money, it is your time, and your decision. I've said that before. I'm just trying to help you become an even more informed consumer. But let's actually chat it up in the comment section below or over there on Twitter. You rock those beautiful faces, and I'll catch you right back here on the next one.